Hi, welcome back to ODE YouTube channel. If you like the videos I make, please don't forget to subscribe and eventually like this video. Today I'm going to present you another pen from Caveco, and this pen was sent to me by Caveco for review purposes. So let's start. And the pen that I have here is the Caveco Perkeo All Black. And it says here what the pen is about. Perkeo is an ink cartridge fountain pen. The design stems from the classic Caveco tradition. The matte octagonal cap and 16-edged barrel harmonize perfectly. The ergonomical grip section ensures an effortless writing experience. So, this pen is marketed as a school pen. It comes in a blister like this. There is the F nib, the F to state the nib. It comes with three blue ink cartridges. And here it is. This is already open. I already used the pen, so it is inked and kept and inked. Let's see if it will write well. And let's take the pen out. Okay. The part of the three ink cartridges will go away. And let's take a look at the pen. And so, this pen is, as I was telling you, like it's a kind of a school pen. It's intended for children. It is a plastic pen. It is quite affordable, less than 20 euros. And you can see that is made for children because it has there some a circular hole to ensure that you can still breathe even if you swallow the cap of the pen, and there is also the same opening on the bottom of the barrel. So about this pen, forget about eyedropping it. What are the characteristics of the pen? It has an octagonal shaped cap, very similar with the cap of the Caveco Sport, and it has a long barrel that tapers down to the end with 16 edges or 16 faces. When you open the cap, which is a click in place, you'll find a triangular section, as you may see here, and a quite small nib for the size of the pen, which is kind of a number 5 nib, slightly different from the Caveco Sport nibs. This one is black. Also, the logo on the top of the cap is black, and all the pen is black. There is why it is called All Black. About the insides, we can unscrew the barrel, and inside we can put an ink cartridge and have another one left in store. So it takes an international cartridge or converter. And this is pretty much what this pen is about. It's quite light. About holding the pen, it is a very quite long pen, so you don't really need to post. It's easier to use like that. It has this triangular shape for you to know how to write with the pen. The good thing about this is that these edges are not sharp, but I would prefer a normal grip than a triangular grip. I'm not a big fan of triangular grips. If you need to post the pen, it posts securely, but it posts quite high. It doesn't become top heavy because it is a light pen, so you will not feel that, but I don't feel the need to do such a thing. So this is a nice inexpensive pen that can be used for students. That's why we have the three faces on the section, but I think anyone can use this pen, like a very relaxed pen that you can take everywhere, because you will not lose a lot of money if you lose it or break it. Now, I want to show you some comparisons. Two pens with which I want to compare it is with this Faber-Castell writing and the Lamy Safari All Black. All these pens are black, so quite similar in their features. However, the Perkeo is the cheapest one of those. The Faber-Castell has a round grip. Also, it has a nib that is not that big for the pen, but the grip is rounded, which I prefer. And the Lamy Safari has the same kind of triangular grip as the Perkeo. And also a black nib. However, let me focus this. I find that the edges on the Lamy, like this one and this one, are much, much sharper than the edges on the Caveco. So I find it much more comfortable to use the Caveco Perkeo than the Lamy Safari, in my opinion. Another comparison I want to do is to show it side by side with the Parker Centennial Lufold and with the Lamy Safari, and it is about the same kind of size. It becomes a little bit more less exciting when you compare the size of the nibs of these two pens. The overall length is about the same, even if the Parker has a bigger nib, but the nib of the Caveco is much, much smaller. Another pen with which I want to compare this one is with a Caveco. This one is a Caveco Art Sport Generation 3. This is called Tiger Eye, but it is Caveco Sport. So the difference between Caveco Perkeo and Caveco Sport is the length of the barrel. The length of the cap is also bigger on the Sport. This one has a screw-in cap, and that one has a push fit cap. If you post it, the Perkeo becomes much, much bigger. If you compare them side by side, the Sport posted, because it is meant to be posted, and the Perkeo not posted, the Sport is a little bit bigger. And so this is all I have for the pen. Let's look at the pen, ink and paper. How does that perform? And here we are with the pen and paper. I just want to tell you something more that I forgot to say before, is that two things. First, the faceted cap helps the pen not to roll easily, so it is well done, and most of the weight is on the cap, so it really prevents rolling. Also, another thing, this pen, unlike Caveco Sport, it doesn't have a slip-in clip as the Caveco Sport. However, you can force, if you open it a little bit, you can force a Caveco Sport clip into this pen. And so, let's write with it and show it how it performs. And this is the Caveco Perkeo All Black with a fine nib. The paper is the usual Rhodia.pad, and the ink inside is Caveco Pearl Black. And what can I see about this pen? First of all, I would say that this pen writes well, but it is a little dry. At least that's how I feel it. It is smooth. It has some feedback. I think you can hear it. But it writes well. I have one problem specific with this pen, is that I don't tend to grip it the correct way. And so I'm always rotating and then it skips sometimes because I take it out of the correct angle. About the line, this is a fine nib and it actually performs as a fine. If you try to write in reverse, it gets dry, it doesn't write, and there is no point to do that because the section, the grip section, is made to be held this way, the proper way, not the reverse side. So forget about reverse writing with this pen. About the wetness, you may see, I would say this is quite a dry pen. I know it looks like more wet than it really is. It smeared a little, but the feeling you have is that it's quite dry, the nib on this pen. However, it writes well and it can cope with fast writing, so I don't see a big problem there. About line variation, that is something that some people like. You can force it and you can see some, but you are feeling that you're really pushing the nib into the paper. So maybe it doesn't make that so much sense to do that, risking to ruin your pen. So this is a nice pen that comes ready to use with the ink cartridges inside that little blister. I think it is a good gift for kids and for someone who is starting on fountain pens. The overall is that it is a nice pen, but I would prefer this pen without the triangular shape on the grip. And also, I feel that the plastic of this pen is much less resistant than the plastic on the regular Caveco Sport. But we have to see that this is cheaper and it is meant for school purposes. So, after all, I think it is a good deal. And so, I have to thank you all for watching the video and also thank Caveco for providing me this pen for review purposes. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next video. Bye.